How do you determine if a painting is real or fake?
A deep intuition that cannot be put into words, followed by scrupulous analysis of the painter's technique, composition, and color palette. And should it pass this rigorous process, the final arbiter is the application of alcohol to a tiny portion of the canvas. Oil paints dry and harden over time, and by that I mean decades, even a century. If the paint dissolves, it's a fake. Let me demonstrate for you. It's completely safe, I assure you. No paint, no forgery.
And this technique is foolproof.
When it comes to oil paint, you simply can't cheat time.
Thank you, Mr. Hanneman.
Ladies and gentlemen, the supper at the Imam's.
It became my passion after critics like Dirk Hanneman destroyed my career years earlier.
So you painted all these as sort of revenge?
And others, which are not here today. They are hanging in the Rijksmuseum, the Boijmans, even in the National Gallery of Art in the capital of the United States of America. And I painted them not as revenge, but to bring more beauty into the world, more of a mirror. There is simply not enough.
And tell us how you might pass the alcohol test Mr. Hanneman described.
Same way I pass every alcohol test, with flying colors.
Mr. Van Mechelen,
answer the question.
I use a very common plastic resin called Bakelite. Invented in 1908, it was the first plastic. And when it's heated, it perfectly emulates the hardness and consistency of centuries-old paint. So Mr. Hanneman can douse it in alcohol all day if he so chooses, and he won't succeed in removing any of it.
And what challenges does one face?
Because the Bakelite is mixed into the pigments, it makes it very difficult to compose with.
Mm-hmm. And then?
I must also find canvas and frame from the correct period. They are impossible to duplicate. Once the canvas is stripped, I then must create an unmistakably original work. I have studied every one of Vermeer's brushstrokes. I understand perfectly the pressure he applied, the movement of his wrist, even the hairs that he's chosen for each brush. I also understand how he mixes his pigments, as well as how he interprets light.
So you try to emulate genius?
Yes, but more than that, I must also weave the present into the past to make the viewer my co-conspirator. So it not only fools the mind, it tugs at the heart. Look at my lace maker. Is she from Vermeer's time? No. She is a jazz age flapper, and she arouses you, yes? And if you look closely at this young lady here, you may recognize the face of Greta Garbo. Goering was no different. At the Olympics in 36, I learned of the kind of art he liked. So when I painted Adulteress, I gave him his very own Nazi Jesus. He believed he was gazing at a 300-year-old painting, but as Narcissus, he would see his own eternity in that canvas. His thousand-year Reich. Never once occurred to him the painting was a fake.
And Mr. Van Meegeren, your views on fascism?
I despise it intensely. I believe every fascist deserves to be swindled.
Thank you.